How can you know how effective your product protection system is? What should you always keep in mind? Hi everyone, welcome to this new episode of our series, The Secret Heroes of Personal Care, where you get to learn about those discreet yet essential ingredients. I am María Teresa Fontanyanes, and in our class today, we are going to explore how to measure the efficacy of our secret heroes. When products become spoiled or microbiologically contaminated, the outcome might be undesirable on many levels. Not only the product will no longer be safe for use, but also it might become aesthetically unpleasant. It could tarnish the brand reputation or even cause financial damages if there is a recall of the product. To avoid scenarios like this and fulfill local regulatory requirements, products routinely get tested for preservative efficacy. The goal of this mandatory step is to stress the preservation system of the product before it reaches the market and make adjustments if needed. Formulators often wonder which preservative efficacy test method, also referred to as PET, to work with. The number of available methods can indeed be overwhelming. For example, there are official compendia such as the United States Pharmacopeia, shortened as USP, or the European Pharmacopeia. Then there are other organizations that have outlined efficacy tests as well, like ISO, ASTM, PCPC, AOAC, and so forth. Additionally, some manufacturers or suppliers have established in-house tests. Even though the fundamental nature of the test doesn't change, there are small procedural differences from method to method. Some of the parameters that differ from one procedure to another are the acceptance of log reduction of the microbiological growth, additional test time points, and the use of additional strains. On the screen, you can see an overview of the commonly used methods. For example, the overview shows that the European Pharmacopeia Criteria A test is the most stringent, requiring a 2 and 3 log reduction of bacteria growth only after 2 and 7 days, respectively. None of the other methods require such a log reduction by day 2. For yeast and molds, the European Pharmacopeia Criteria A is also the most demanding method. Interestingly, this table illustrates that the required log reduction for bacteria is more restrictive than for mold. And in fact, bacteria generally responds faster to preservatives while yeast and molds are eliminated at a slower rate. Preservative challenge tests always deal with some degree of risk management. The organisms tested are not necessarily the ones that may later cause issues. The organism of concern could be some unknown environmental contaminant. But the assumption is, if the standard test organisms get killed, commonly occurring spoilage organisms will be eradicated as well. Unfortunately, there is never a guarantee. Products that often receive special attention with regards to preservative performance are those designed for use on children and babies, as well as products that are applied on the eye area. Here, there can be further distinction between rinse-off, products that are washed off the skin, and leave-on, meaning those products that are left on the skin for which there might be a higher risk of adverse reaction if they become contaminated. Formulations containing ingredients that can act as nutrient sources for microorganisms, like sugars, need special attention as well. These nutrient-rich formulations may promote the growth of organisms compared to other formulations that are more simple. Now you know more about the variety of norms that exist to control the preservative efficacy in your formulations. Each company has its own rules, and therefore we recommend you to check what are the standards of yours. At Symrise, we make sure to offer solutions that pass the most challenging requirements. We start every preservative challenge test assessing the worst-case condition in terms of microorganisms concentration and type. Additionally, we avoid fragrance ingredients in the base formulations, as some fragrances are known to have antimicrobial efficacy. Well, this is it for today. As we have just seen in this episode, preservative challenge tests are an effective way to test if a cosmetic formula will likely be safe and stable over its shelf life and later in consumers' hands. There are many different methods available with different requirements, and therefore, before deciding on a testing strategy, risk factors have to be taken into account. At Symrise, we support you to design a product that is sufficiently protected using modern product protection ingredients. Thank you.
Symrise. Always inspiring more.